Good morning, everybody. My name is Javier González. I am marine geologist at the Geological Survey of Spain, and I will start the presentation of our research under the GeoEra program. The first one will be the presentation on the marine deposits, and later Daniel will present the second part of our talk. The GeoEra program is an international European program funded by the geological organizations from 32 European countries and also with the participation of the European Commission to establish the European Geological Service based on four kinds of projects. The first one is the groundwater projects, second one, the raw material projects, the third one, the geoenergy projects, and finally, the information platform for all these projects. In total, we have 15 research projects funded under GeoEra program. Within the GeoEra raw material projects, we have four different projects: Eurolithus, centered in the ornamental stones in Europe; frame project, focused on the critical raw materials on land deposits; the mine DC project, focused on the in seabed mineral deposits; and the Mintel for Europe, that is centered on focused on the minerals intelligence for Europe. All this project is assist in identifying high potential areas in Europe for the responsible sourcing of critical materials. And all of these projects are in line with the European Green Deal, but also with the new industrial strategy or the strategy for data meet with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. Well, within this GeoEra raw material projects, the Mine DC project is focused on the seabed mineral deposits in the European seas. The project is formed by a consortium of 12 partners, essentially European Geological Service, but also with partners from the USA Geological Survey, but also Portugal, Russia, and Spain. The project is formed by eight work packages for a study of hydrothermal sulfides, ferromanganese grass and phosphorites, placers, polymetallic nodules, and exploration. This project is meeting with an important challenge, that is the study of the seafloor deposits, the most important yet unexplored resource for critical raw materials. We know that, for instance, the cobalt or nickel is more concentrated in the submarine deposits than in the onland deposits. And for the future, the economy, the world economy will be more centered, more and more centered in the seabed deposits. In the slide, you can see on the right side one graphical chart with the contents of different metals, strategic and critical metals like cobalt, nickel, molybdenum, or copper, and the enrichment in the onland and seabed deposits. And also, you can see below the critical raw materials table for 2020 critical raw materials table of elements considered by the European Commission as critical for Europe, for our development. And most of them are very concentrated in the marine deposits. Okay. Under the Mine DC project, we are doing a work of characterization of the European deposit types and their critical raw materials for hydrothermal mineralizations, seafloor massive sulfides, so for instance, Also for cobalt-rich ferromanganese crust, like the crust that are occurring in many seamounts around the European continental margins, and also on phosphorites, also enriched in many of these continental margins, but also for polymetallic nodules on the seabed abyssal plains and for marine placer deposits. In the slide, you can see some examples of these critical deposits. For instance, on a submarine image on the tropic seamount in the Canary Islands, or a 3D model for the morphological characterization of one of these seamounts, which is occupied by extensive fields of ferromanganese crust, and the distribution of critical elements like cobalt inside this ferromanganese crust. But also we are identifying the mineral metallogenic province in the European seas, with establishing the mineral assemblage, the areas of distribution, the periods of formation for all these kinds of mineralization, and the genetic models. In the slide, you can see in the corner the map for areas of distribution of ferromanganese crust in the Atlantic Ocean, but also you can see below one metallogenic model for different kinds of hydrothermal mineralization in the Canary Islands, or the distribution in the ternary diagram of classification of polymetallic nodules in different areas like in Baltic, Mediterranean, or the Atlantic Ocean. But we are also using cutting-edge technologies, not only on board, like the ROV equipments, to take many different kinds of data, like a very high resolution image on the seafloor up to 6,000 meters of depth, but also in the laboratories. We are obtaining very nice data on different critical elements like lithium, like cobalt, or rare elements in the submarine deposits. At the same time, we are developing harmonized mineral maps and data sets with all this data on the occurrence in Europe. For instance, in this slide, you can see here the map for energy critical elements, cobalt and lithium, based on ferromanganese deposits. And in the map, we can see the examples for ferromanganese crust in the Macaronesia and Iberian coast in the Atlantic Ocean, very enriched in cobalt, that are linked with a process of hydrogenesis from the sea waters, and in the north of the Atlantic and the Arctic, and also in the Baltic, we can see different enrichments in lithium, in manganese nodules and concretions linked to diagenetic processes. We are also demonstrating the efficiency of the case studies results. For instance, in this slide, you can see two examples, one in the Baltic Sea for ferromanganese concretions, very enriched in manganese and iron in the Baltic Sea, and the study of these cases for the assessment of the government and the European Commission, but also in the tropic seamount in the Canary Islands area, when we are studying the contents of different critical elements like rare elements and cobalt, estimating the contents of these elements for 1 square kilometer of this seamount. With all this data, we have compiled more than 680 occurrences for 5 types of mineral deposits in the pan-European seas in more than 15 million square kilometers, and obtaining very nice new data for new resources like cobalt, tellurium, niobium, rare elements, lithium, and others, indicating the high potential of some areas in the ocean and seas around Europe, like in the Macaronesia, or the Baltic, or the Arctic Ocean. Finally, we are also analyzing the present-day exploration and exploitation status, the regulation, legislation, and environmental impacts, and the exploitation of future directions in relation with, for instance, the developing of the regulatory framework in the International Seabed Authority for the exploitation of mineral resources, but also in line with the development of our society with the necessity of new kinds of mineral resources for the development of high technology, for green technology, for green energy. And that's all from my side. Thank you.